Okay, so today we're going to be learning how to change RDP session timeout on Windows server, desktop server. So you realize that if you have a Windows server or Windows machine and you connected to a virtual machine where you log in via RDP, so you will find that after you are inactive for some time, probably hours or even minutes, the RDP session will be automatically timed out and logged out. So to prevent that, it's what we're going to be doing in this tutorial, to make sure that you can be the session can still be alive even after you logging out or terminating your window or RDP window. So for as long as all the time, it will always be alive. So let me go ahead and log into my server first. And then we can proceed on that. Okay, so now I'm logging into my server. And now next we're gonna be visiting our settings. Okay, this is all my work that I'm doing on my server, and I wouldn't want it to close at any one point. So just want it to keep open, such that it can keep on running all this code of mine, because if it closes, then the code will stop running. So it's a Python code. So to keep the RDP desktop live session still live and preventing it from logging out or terminating, you will have to first of all come to your Windows settings. Okay. Okay, so next go to your Windows settings or app, then search for local group policy. Local group policy. Yeah, I think this is group policy. Okay. Okay, but it would be better, I think, if you search it from here. Okay. Let me hope this is a group policy. Okay. Let's try this. Okay, so this is the local group policy for Windows 11 Pro. So. And actually, it's actually the same for all Windows, Windows 10, Windows 11, and also Windows, I think, 8, and so on. So, but most importantly is to have this log group policy, then we start our configuration. So, first of all, we shall go for administrative, of course, under the local computer policy. We shall go for administrative templates, but still under the computer configuration. So this is how it goes. It starts with the local group policy, then computer configuration, then after that go for administrative templates. So you click on administrative templates, it will unfold, then below inside the drop down you will see Windows components. So these are the Windows components. So you also drop the Windows components, and under the Windows components we're just interested in remote desktop services. So we're going to be looking for remote desktop services under this. Ours are remote desktop services. Where so you look for remote desktop services. Okay, here it is, remote desktop services. You drop down this also. I think I should make it a little bit bigger. And then under this, you will see what we call remote desktop session host. Remote desktop session host. So we are interested in this last one, remote desktop session host. So you drop down this, and then after that we are now going for session time limits. So you can see at the bottom we have session time limit. So you double click on that, and the session time limit settings and configuration will be displayed on the right side here. So you have set time limit for disconnected sessions like RDP. It's already enabled, but you can disenable it or disconnect it by clicking on it. Can actually double tap. Then the settings will come for set time limit for disconnected sessions. You can see it is enabled, but you can just disable this such that you end all sessions. So if it is enabled, you're saying set time limit for disconnected sessions, and then under the end a disconnected session you have to choose never. So if it's not enabled, you go ahead and enable it. If it is disabled, go ahead and click on enabled, and after enabling it, click on the end disconnected session should be in never, then go ahead and apply and click on OK. So you will see that you have never, and therefore every disconnected user, RDP user, will never be limited out or set out or logged out automatically, even when the RDP is actually closed. So set time limit for active but idle remote desktop users. For example, people who are active but they're idle, they're not present. So it might be currently be disabled. You can go ahead and enable it, and then go for idle session time limits. Just say never and then click on OK. Come back for set time limit for active remote desktop sessions. You open the session, and therefore you can also set up the setting. If it is disabled, you can go ahead and enable it, and then under the active session limit, click on never and then OK. So we also have end session when time limits are reached. Click on it, and then it is disabled. Yes, of course. Why am I disabling it? Or if you say enable, then you're not gonna be having anything here. So if at all they had an option of saying never, we would go ahead and say never, but we don't have the option, so we take it back to disable. So we are disabling the end session when time limits are reached. So whenever time limits are reached for the RDP, there will not be time limit session or ending the time a session. So all that said, you are done setting up all ending time limit sessions in Windows, of course, server. So after this, you can just cancel the server or close the RDP, and hopefully all these transactions and all closed, or I mean opened windows, will continue to be open, and all processes will continue to move as smooth as possible. For example, forever, even if it is a year, until your server is expired. So that's all, guys. Thanks for watching. See you in the next tutorial.